Hello everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft. This is video designer Jayashree this side. Today I'm sharing with you a creative way to make your own floral fairy light string using shrink print sheets from Dress My Craft. But before we get started, please do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest videos. To begin with, I have die cut my shrink print sheets using the big flower die set from Dress My Craft. I have used the two biggest sizes for die cutting from this set of 5 dies. Now shrink print sheets are made up of a shrink plastic material which shrinks down to almost 1/3 of its original size when heated. These sheets are glossy on one side and frosted or matte on the other side. To make my flowers, I am using today alcohol inks on these sheets. You can use a variety of colors or inks on these sheets, ranging from distress inks to pencil colors to soft pastels to Copic markers. The possibilities are endless. In case you don't have a die cutting machine, you can even print your template on these sheets and then hand cut it. To use the alcohol inks, I am going to place my flower die cut glossy side up. In case you are using pencil colors or watercolors, you can use the frosted side up. I am going to use Tim Holtz alcohol inks in the color Coral, Valencia and Dandelion. I am simply adding a drop of alcohol ink on my flower die cut first, then adding a bit of isopropyl to it and then spreading it with the paintbrush. I am going to repeat the same process for my next color on the petals of the flower. I'm spreading it with paintbrush to get a full coverage along with a paint effect. You can choose to use your blower to spread the ink for an abstract look. I am using the colors Violet and Butterscotch from Beyond Inks. I am again repeating the same process of painting. Once all the die cuts are colored, I left them to completely air dry. Do not use your heat tool to dry these as it will shrink your paper instantly. Now before shrinking these flowers, I am going to make a small center hole in them. For this, I am simply piercing through using my scissors and placing the die cut on a perforating embossing pad from Dress My Craft. After piercing, I am just trimming off the extra pieces of sheet hanging out to form a circle. If you are making smaller flowers, then you can use the hand punches from Dress My Craft. But since these are huge flowers, I am piercing holes. Now it's time to see the magic of shrink print. I am using here my embossing foam pad from Dress My Craft covered with a cotton cloth. I am placing the flower again glossy side up using my heat resistant tweezers from Dress My Craft in the flower center to hold it in place and then start to heat it using my heat tool. I'm rotating my heat tool so that the heat is distributed equally all over the flower. Also, since I'm using alcohol inks, I have kept a distance of at least 3 inches so that my sheet doesn't catch fire or doesn't get overheated. Once the sheet is properly heated, it starts to dance and curl and shrink. Don't worry when it starts to curl like this. It will come to its original shape once it's completely shrunk. Now, while it's still hot, I'm using my tweezers to mold the petals and give them a natural curly look. And here you can see how beautiful this flower looks already. Let's do all of these other flower petals as well. All the flowers, I'm using here a fairy light I had at home. I'm going to insert the bulb part of the light into the center hole we created and adhere it using B6000. Also, I'm making sure to keep the flowers upside down so that the bulb remains in its place and the glue dries properly. If you think the hole is too big for the light bulb, you can put it in a slanting manner and adhere it. Try not to move the light string too much and let the glue dry for a couple of hours so that the flowers get stuck properly. Light ready for use. You can decorate your rooms, Christmas trees, or anything else for that matter. I hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial and are inspired to make your own too. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye bye.